Hi guys, our discussion for today is about three-moment equation. No? So three-moment equation is actually a single algebraic equation that is used in solving continuous beams. Actually, pwede rin naman siyang, we can also use the three-moment equation in solving deflections and slope no? at a certain point of a single span beam or simply supported beam. But our main focus for today is about how to use three-moment equation in analyzing continuous beams. So meaning we will be dealing with statically indeterminate beams here. So there are actually two cases. The first one is if we have continuous beam and the end supports are just simple supports, meaning hinge or roller. And on the other case, we have a single span beam or a continuous beam with end supports as fixed. Bakit natin siya hinati into two cases? Because if we will be dealing with fixed supports, may ginagawa tayong part doon, which is actually we are putting an imaginary span. So before we solve continuous beams using the three-moment equation, let us just first derive kung ano ba yung three-moment equation na meron tayo. Okay? So for example, we have here, may kumakahol na aso, no? Natin siya. Anyways, for example, we have here a beam, no? Let's say simply supported beam. And that simply supported beam is subjected to a varying load. Okay? Then let's have three points on that beam. So let's say this is point one. Or much better, let's have the points in letters na lang. No? So let's have point A. This is, let's say, point B. And this is point C. Okay? Now, obviously, this beam will have a corresponding moment diagram or moment values or moment function. Let's say this is your moment diagram. Lagyan natin dito para hindi nakakaano, no? So this is your moment diagram. So let's project those points. Okay. And let's consider or let's name the areas of the moment diagram under these two segments or these three points. So let's say this is A1 and this is A2. So since we named it as subscript 1 and subscript 2, let's also use the length of the first segment, which is segment AB, to be length 1. And let's have the length of the second segment, which is segment BC, to be L2. Okay? So this is the corresponding moment diagram. But if we will be putting end moments no, on the beam, it will obviously have another moment diagram. It will actually in a decreasing value from the end support papunta dun sa gitna. No? So let's have here, let's say moment diagrams, no? Caused by end moments, applied end moments. Okay, so again, since this is point A, let's say this is moment A, caused by applied end moment. And let's say this is moment at B and moment at C. Remember, moments A, B, and C are actually the moments caused by the applied end moments. Okay, now, how do we now compute for the three-moment equation? So the first is, let's look at the diagram. And let's look, ano ba yung magiging itsura ng deformation ng beam natin. So obviously, if we will be drawing first the elastic curve, magiging ganito siya. So this is actually point A, this is point B, and point C, meaning these are their deformed locations or the the location on the elastic curve based on the given load. So, drawing natin. Okay? Where B is the lowest point, no? So, let's draw. Okay? So, let's say this is point A. This is project natin. Oh, hindi tumama, pero let's, ano, no? This is point B. And this is point C. Okay? So, let's project a reference tangent line. So, let's say point B is the lowest point. Oh, sorry, not the lowest point, but let's project a... Let's project a reference line. So, let's say this is our reference line. Or the reference, or reference line. Then, let's say point B is somewhere not in the middle, but let's just project a tangent at point B. Let's say point B has a negative sloping slope, no? So, pag nag-project ako dyan ng tangent line, this will be actually paganyan, no? So, okay. So, let's say this is your tangent line of point B. Okay? So, as you can see, we can project distances here, no? So, based on, let's review the, what we call the moment area theorem. Ano ba yung tawag natin sa vertical distance between the elastic curve and the reference line? That is actually what we call the deflection. So, in this case, let's say this is h na lang. Okay? Then, on the other hand, ito naman yung kabila. From, again, from the elastic curve, papunta dun sa reference line natin. So, this is defined as, let's say, HA. How about the tangential deviation? How do we define tangential deviation? So, we define tangential deviation as actually as, or we define tangential deviation as the vertical distance from the point of the elastic curve up to the reference tangent line. So, kung papansin nyo at point C, we can use the reference tangent line hanggang dito sa, ito, sa point na yan, no? Which is actually tangent B. So, this is actually the tangential deviation of point C with respect to tangent line B. Okay? How about sa kabila? So, ganun din. Ito, hanggang dito sa point na to, that is your tangential deviation of A with respect to reference tangent line B. So, as you can see, itong tangent line na to, and we have itong, let's say, here, no? Ito pong reference line natin. If we project its vertical distance from the tangent line papunta dun sa reference tangent, and again, ito tangent line papunta dun sa reference tangent, we are having actually a similar triangle. So, project natin yung similar triangle na yan. No? So, ito daw yan. Pilitin natin tumama sa gitna. Yan. Okay? So, this is daw yung point B. So, we have two similar triangles. So, based on the similar triangle, we can use ratio and proportion. But the question first is, ano daw po yung distance na to? So, based on the diagram, as you can see, itong buong to is HA. But mula dito hanggang dito sa tangential deviation of A with respect to B. Meaning, this distance is actually HA minus the tangential deviation of A with respect to B. On the other hand, on the other side rather, itong buong to is a tangential deviation of C with respect to B. Ang kailangan ko itong distance lang na to. So that will give you the tangential deviation of C with respect to B minus HC. And let's go back on the distances we have here, your LA, L1 rather, and L2. So this is L1 and L2. Okay? Now, By using ratio and proportion, we have here your HA minus the tangential deviation of A with respect to B divided by L1 equals the tangential deviation of C with respect to B minus H2 divided by L2. Okay? Here, we need to define ano yung tangential deviation of A with respect to B and what is the tangential deviation of C with respect to B. Okay? So, paano natin siya gagawin? Let's go back on again in our moment area theorem. Okay? So, paano daw natin dinidefine yung tangential deviation? Tangential deviation is actually based on the second moment area theorem. And it is defined as 1 over EI multiplied by the area of the moment diagram multiplied by the centroid of that diagram papunta dun sa point on the elastic curve na kinoconsider natin. So in this case, let's have here the tangential deviation of A with respect to B. So sabi natin, it's just 1 over EI multiplied by the area of the moment diagram between points A and B. Saan po yun? Ito po yan. Diba? Point A, point B, point A, point B. So, kailangan ko lang daw yung area nitong dalawang diagram then multiplied by its centroid. So, project natin. So, let's say yung centroid nito, let's define it as, let's say, A bar. Okay? Dahil nasa length 1 siya, lagyan natin ng 1. Tapos, let's say ito is on the right side, let's say that is B bar. Okay? And lagyan natin siya ng 2. So, para sa yung A and B? So, para lang magkaroon tayo ng notations, yung A natin, gagamitin natin siya yung notation A kapag yung distance papunta sa kaliwa, tapos yung B pag papunta sa kanan. Yung subscript, it shows kung ano yung length na kinukonsider natin. So, ibig sabihin kung yung distance ko papunta dito, that will become B bar 1. And kapag yung centroid naman ng A papunta dito, that will become A bar kasi pakaliwa, tapos length 2. Okay? Now, we need to have the tangential deviation of A with respect to B. So, ibig sabihin kailangan ko po itong area na to. So, that's actually A1 because A1 is represented or is considered as a notation for the area of this moment diagram multiplied sa centroid. Distance ng centroid ng papunta saan? That is area 1 papunta sa A. Bakit po? Kasi sabi natin tangential deviation of A. Meaning, we are considering the point on the elastic curve which is point A with respect to tangent line B. So, ang kailangan ko pong centroid is A1. So, this is A1 bar. Okay, meron pa bang moment diagram na hindi natin na-consider? Meron pa. Ito pong baba, no? So, paano ba natin siya hatiin para pinakamadali? Obviously, para pinakamadali is to form a triangle. Kasi trapezoid yan eh. Kaysa sa mag-form pa tayo ng rectangle, no? So, let's have two triangles. Para hindi na tayo magbabawas ang MA sa MB kung magre-rectangle pa ako, medyo komplikado yon, no? So, ang gagawin natin, itong area na to, no? So, since ang area lang naman ng triangle, as long as we have a base and a perpendicular height. No, when we say height, it should always perpendicular to the base. And that is actually MA. No, kahit ano pang orientation yan, we can compute the area of the triangle as 1 half base times height. So in this case, that is 1 half of MA times L1. Area pa lang yon. So lagyan natin dito. So plus 1 half of MA L1. Okay? Nakikita niyo pa ba ito? Okay. Usog-usog lang natin. Next. How about yung triangle sa baba? 1 half base times height. But the magnitude of that diagram is MB. Okay? So, this plus 1 half of MB. Again, its base is still L1. Sorry. May nakalimutan tayo, no? Naka-multiply pa pala to, itong dalawang to, kasi sabi natin, the tangential deviation is, it should also be the area multiplied by the centroid. Ano yung centroid ng triangle? Ano ba yung centroid nito? Papunta dito. Sa side. So that is 1/3 of L. So dapat ito nakamultiply pa ng L1 over 3.
Okay.
Itong part na to nakamultiply din sa centroid niya. Ito, papunta
dito.
And papunta siya dun sa vertex, meaning that is 2/3 of L1. So this is multiplied by 2/3 of L1. Okay. So wala na, no? Yun lang yung moment diagram between points A and B. So let's simplify. So this is just 1 over EI multiplied by A1 bar plus 1 over 6 ng MA L1 plus 2 over 6 ng MB, sorry, naka-squared pala kasi L1 times L1 times L1 squared. Okay, now how about the tangential deviation of C with respect to B? So we have 1 over EI multiplied by the area of the moment diagram. Ito muna tayo. So that is actually A2. Papunta daw sa C. Bakit? Kasi tangential deviation of C. So ang distance is B bar 2. So we have A2 multiplied by B bar 2 plus the area of the moment diagram. Itong trapezoid ulit. Hatiin na lang ulit natin, no? So yung centroid nito papunta dito, that is L2 over 3. Ito naman, papunta dito, that is 2/3 ng L2. Okay? So, anong area muna nito? That is 1/2 base times height. So, 1/2 ng MC multiplied by L2 multiplied by its centroid papunta sa sides. That will give you L2 over 3 plus yung area ng triangle na to. That will give you 1/2 of MB multiplied by 2/3 of L2. So let's simplify. That will give you 1 over EI multiplied by A2 B bar 2 plus 1 over 6 ng MC L2 squared plus 2 over 6 ng MB L2 squared. Okay? So we now have the values of the two tangential deviations na nakuha natin kanina doon sa ratio and proportion natin. So let's now substitute it on the ratio and proportion. So sabi niya HA, actually kung papansin niyo pwede ko siyang ihiwalay, no? Paghiwalay natin HA over L1. Okay, para mas mabilis, we have HA over L1 minus the tangential deviation of A with respect to B divided by L1. So, kung papansin nyo, itong tangential deviation of A with respect to B, i-divide daw natin yan ng L1 lahat. So, we have minus, then we have A1 bar over L1. Tingin dito, susulat natin dito. Plus, divide by L1 daw, so magiging MA L1 na lang over 6 plus 2MB L1 na lang ulit divide by 6 equals, ito naman, tangential deviation of C with respect to B daw, divide by L2. So ito, i-divide natin siya ng L2. By the way, nawala po yung EI, no? Isama ulit natin 1 over EI. Okay? Then we have 1 over EI equals, divide lang natin daw lahat to ng L2. So that will give you B bar divide by L2 plus MC L2 na lang kasi i-divide to ng L2. This is over 6 plus 2MB L2 na lang over 6 minus H2 over L2. Ito po yan. Hindi, parang pinaghiwalay lang natin yung numerator natin. Okay, so let's have another paper. Okay, so let's look. Kung papansin nyo, pwede po natin pagsamahin yung H2L2. So ang gawin natin is, ilipat natin to sa side na to, then yung H2H magkasama dito. So we have HA over L1 magiging plus, okay, plus H, this is not H2, no, this is HB. Kanina pa tayo, HC, no? Doon sa derivation natin. Kasi siya po yung vertical distance sa point C. So this is HC over L2 equals, lipat natin sa kabilang side, i-factor out natin yung 1 over EI. Okay. Factor out natin yung 6. So lagyan natin siya dito ng 6 multiplied by. So since pinactor out natin yung 6, magkakaroon dapat to ng times 6, no? So that will give you 6A1 bar over L1 plus MA L1 plus 2MB L1. Ipa-plus lang natin to, plus dahil nilabas nga natin yung 6EI, so magkakaroon din to ng 6. 6A2 B bar 2 over L2 plus MC L2 plus 2MB L2. Okay, so balik tayo natin, ilipat natin to sa side ng equation na to. That will give you MA L1 plus, kung papansin nyo, dalawa po yung 2MB. So factor out natin yung 2MB. That will give you L1 plus L2. Tama? Plus MC L2. Okay. Copy naman natin. Hindi na natin ito kailangan. MC L2. Plus, we have your 6A1 A1 bar over L1 plus 6A2 B2 bar over L2 equals, cross multiply natin, that will give you 6EI over, I multiplied by HA over L1 plus HC over L2. This equation is actually our three moment equation, where MA is defined as the moment at point A, L1, MB is the moment at point B, MC is the moment at point C, L1 and L2 are the distances of the two segments, okay, HA is the vertical distance from the elastic curve papunta sa reference line, meaning deflection po yan ng point A. Likewise with HC, that is the vertical distance of point C on the elastic curve papunta po dun sa reference line natin. In that case, this will be defined as the deflection at point C. Okay, obviously EI is defined as what we call the flexural rigidity. Okay, so ibig sabihin, if we will be considering or we will be analyzing continuous beams, tapos yung endpoints natin, point A and point C, are naka-level or of same elevation ng point B, automatic HA and HC will be considered as zero. That's why in most cases, when kung nakakakita po kayo ng equation ng three moment, ang ginagamit po is ito lang, tapos naka-equal po siya sa zero. But this is the general equation of the three moment equation. And that is how we, ang kailangan lang natin is, if you don't want to derive, you can actually memorize this equation. So, ano ba yung value po ng 6A1 A1 over L1 saka 6A2 B2 over L2? Actually, if you will be considering textbooks, medyo marami siyang formula depende po sa loading. Pero, sobrang typical saka sobrang basic lang po ng loading na nandun sa book, mga books natin. So, what if hindi typical yung binigay sa inyong loading? O kaya, paano kung binigyan po kayo ng loading na, let's say, naka-spandrel type? Okay, so ano kayang gagawin natin? Okay, so ang gagawin lang natin is we will just be considering ano daw po ba yung formula ng 6AA kapag meron po tayong, let's say, concentrated load lang or point load. Okay, so let's say this is L, this is the full length of the span na lang of the segment L1. So if this is A, this is obviously L1 minus A, or it's L over A na lang, no? If we have a point load, yung 6A1 bar natin over L1 is just actually equal to anong formula natin dito? Okay, so we have just P, if I'm not mistaken, no? Yung pababa kasi sa, si Lolo, or that is PAB squared over L squared, that is for the fix and moment. I think this is different. I think this is P times A times L squared minus A squared over L, if I'm not mistaken. But in our next video naman, we will be reviewing it, no? But I think this is correct. Okay, para natin malaman kung tama ba yung equations natin. I think we can check on the values of, or the unit. Kasi pag sinabi natin 6, ano bang magtatingin nyo maging unit ng 6AA over L? Any guess? Obviously, it's kilonewton meter squared. Kasi you can't add actually terms kung magkakaiba ng unit dyan. Dito pa lang, kita mo na kaagad, moment is kilonewton meter times L, so that will give you kilonewton meter squared. Area 1 is actually represented as the area of the moment diagram, meaning based, kung rectangle base times height, that's kilonewton meter times meter, that's kilonewton meter squared, cancel meter. So this should be kilonewton meter squared. So kilonewton tapos meter, that will give you kilonewton meter. Kasi point load is in force lang. So kilonewton times distance A meter. Then we have here meter squared minus meter squared. Then divide by meter. That will give you meter. Then kilonewton meter meter. That will give you kilonewton meter squared. So I guess the equation is correct. So bakit ko ito pinapakita? Kasi po, what if you will be given, let's say, a spandrel loading or any type of loading? Okay, any type of loading. Let's say, sige, spandrel. Paano kaya natin yan malalaman? Okay, let's say this is load W. Let's say this is second degree spandrel. Wala yan sa book, no? Most of the reference books natin, wala namang equivalent na PA, na, oh, sorry, walang equivalent na 6AA over L1. Okay, so ano daw gagawin natin? Ang gagawin natin is actually, alam naman natin when we are getting the area of a given function, it's just actually equal to the its integral. So, ibig sabihin, kung we will be computing for 6AA over L1, it is just actually equal to the integral of the point load. So, integral lang yan ng PA L squared A squared over L. Kahit sa fix and moment, ganun yung ginagawa natin. We are actually integrating the formula of the fix and moment of the point load. Okay? Obviously, dx, no? As long as we know the value of P. Okay? At saka yung value ng A natin. Saan yun? Obviously, we will be projecting here, let's say, the equivalent point P. Let's say this is distance x. Obviously, this is L minus x. So, ano-ano ba yun? P must be represented as actually your differential strip dx. So this is always y dx. Okay, so yung P natin will be y dx. Yung A natin is actually your distance x. Okay, then L is the length. Then we will just be integrating it kung hanggang saan lang po yung loading natin. So since in our figure, ang loading ko po is from 0 to L, the limit is from 0 to L. Pero kapag ang diagram ko po is hanggang dito lang, let's say this is 6 meters tapos hanggang 4 lang, ang limit ko po must only be from 0 to 4. Why? Because we are integrating based on the point load. Meaning, it this y dx represents the magnitude at any given point of the load system. So kung hanggang doon lang yung load natin, obviously yun hanggang doon lang po yung i-integrate natin. Okay? And that is how we use the value of the 6AA over L1 of the three moment equation. So we'll be having our example on our next video. So see you on our next video.